Hi everyone, welcome to my chemistry. In this video we are going to discuss about the practice questions which I have taken from CSIR NET. In previous video also we have discussed a lot of examples and practice questions. Let's see one by one. The first question: among the following compound, the compound has the lowest energy barrier for the cis trans isomerization. So see, all the questions are mainly based on the aromaticity. First read the questions carefully. They are asking the lowest energy barrier, the compound which has the lowest energy barrier. For this we have to use aromaticity. So what is the cis trans isomerization? When the cis trans isomerization takes place, so the cis trans isomerization takes place in alkenes, in single bonded compounds. But here if you see the option, they are all consisting of exocyclic double bonds. So cis trans isomerization means the cis form is converted into trans form, or trans form is converted into cis form. So it will happen in the single bond compounds, the carbon carbon having single bond. In case of carbon carbon double bond compounds, the rotation is restricted. Why the rotation is restricted? If you see this bond, it is an exocyclic bond. Here is a carbon, here is a carbon. So this carbon, two carbon is connected with by pi bond. This pi bond is formed by the sideways overlap of p orbital. So the electron density above and below the ring is very high. So this makes rotation is hindered. So we cannot convert the cis into trans form or trans into cis form in the case of alkene molecules, that is double bonded molecules. For this we have to break this exocyclic bond, then they can convert into cis or trans to cis. Let's see. If you break this, so it will take negative charge, so it becomes positive. This ring becomes positive and this become negative. So this now has delocalization. So totally 4 pi electrons. 4 pi electrons means it obeys 4N rule, hence it is anti aromatic. Now it has positive charge. So the 6 pi electrons are involved in the delocalization because it has alternate and double and single bonds. So it obeys 4N plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. Okay. So one if you see the one part of the compound, one is anti-aromatic and another ring is aromatic. So the entire compound will be non-aromatic. Entire compound will be non-aromatic. In this compound, again, it will take negative charge and it will take positive charge. Both the rings are same. It has 5 member ring. This is also a 5 member ring. So it has 6 pi electron. It obeys 4N plus 2 pi rule. Again it is aromatic. Here 4 pi electron. So it obeys anti-aromatic rule. So again the entire system will be non-aromatic. And third, option C, one ring is 7 member ring, another is a 5 member ring. If it is taken by the 5 member ring, it has negative charge. Now it has positive charge. So it has totally 6 pi electron, because this negative charge taking part in the resonance, and this 3 pi bonds has 6 pi electrons. It also is aromatic. It also is aromatic. So both the system are aromatic. So the entire compound will be aromatic. And here it's a trans to each other. It is a 7 member ring. Both the rings are 7 member ring connected by the exocyclic bond. If it is taken either this or this ring, it becomes negative and this becomes positive. So 6 pi electron, it obeys aromatic, and this take negative charge. So totally 8 pi electrons, it obeys anti-aromatic rule. Hence it is anti-aromatic. So the entire system will be non-aromatic. So this compound is, the entire compound is non-aromatic, this is non-aromatic and this is non-aromatic. So the entire system will be aromatic because both the ring are obeying the 4N plus 2 pi rule and has an aromatic nature. So the entire compound will be aromatic, which is highly stable because it has lowest energy barrier. So if it is highly stable, the energy will be less. So this compound will undergo for the cis trans isomerization. So option C is the correct. And second question, among A to C, the aromatic compounds are The three options are given. You see the first option. It is a 10 aniline. It is 10 aniline. We know it 10 aniline as inner hydrogens, two inner hydrogens which experiences van der Waals repulsion. So it is a non-planar molecule. Non-planar molecule, hence it is non-aromatic. Even though this ring and this ring totally it has totally 6 pi electrons, 12 pi electrons. It obeys 4N rule, but it loses its planarity because of this inner two hydrogens. Hence, the 10 aniline is a non-planar and non-aromatic. The option B, the bridged atom is here, oxygen. Oxygen is a bridged atom, so this, it does not give any disturbance to the delocalization. So, hence it has this ring has 6 pi electron and this ring has 6 pi electron. So, totally it obeys aromaticity. So, hence this compound is aromatic. We know that naphthalene is also a aromatic. So, it has 10 pi electron. 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 into 2, 10 pi electron. It obeys 4N plus 2 pi rule and aromatic. So, option B and C both are aromatic compounds. And the third question, the correct order of acidity of the following compound is, when the molecule will be assigned as acidic? If it gives proton from its molecule, and then the compound will be called as acidic. Let's see the acidity of the following compounds. In option A, it's a trifluoromethane, pentatrifluoromethane cyclohexapentadiene system. So if you see, this CF3 groups are electron withdrawing groups, which has minus I effect. So it strongly withdraw the electrons from it, near it. So it removes the hydrogen very fastly and becomes negative. So now this negative charge involved in the delocalization. So totally it has 6 pi electron, hence it is aromatic, stable. After losing its proton, it gives a stable aromatic species. If this cyclopropene system loses its proton, negative charge, so it involved in the delocalization, so totally it has 4 pi electron, it obeys 4N rule, hence it is anti-aromatic. Again, this system substituted cyclopentadiene withdraws a proton. Again, it has 6 pi electron, which is involved in the delocalization. It obeys 4N plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. So, A and C both are aromatic. And which is more acidic? A and C. If you see here, this is CF3 group, which is a minus I effect. So, it highly withdraw the electrons from it. So, it readily removes, the effectively removes the proton from it. So, it becomes more acidic. So, it is more acidic compared to C. So, the acidity will be option A is a more acidic than C because it's aromatic, and option B is least acidic. Okay. Then the fourth question, among the following compounds, the one which has highest dipole moment means high charge separation, maximum charge separation should be there. Maximum charge separation in a molecule. Okay. It's a full valent type compounds which having the two rings are connected by the exocyclic bond. So if it remove the bonds by breaking it, so one will take negative charge and one will take positive charge. So it will take negative and it will take positive. Both the rings are same only. So if you take this ring by negative charge, it has 6 pi electrons. It obeys 4N rule and 4N plus 2 rule and aromatic. And this part, if we count this part, 4 pi electron, it's anti-aromatic. 4 pi electron. So entire system will be non-aromatic. Again, this system, one is 7 member ring and one of this 5 member ring. So if you take negative charge and this take positive charge, this part has 6 pi electron and it obeys 4N plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. If it is this negative charge involved in the delocalization, so totally 1, 2, 3. So it has 6 pi electron in the system. Again, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. So it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule. Both the compound, both the system is aromatic. The entire compound will be aromatic. So it's highly stable. And third option, one is 3-member ring, another one is a 6-member ring. So if its bond is undergo breakage, it taken by the negative charge is taken by the 3-member ring and this positive charge. So it has 6 pi electron. So it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule. Hence it is aromatic. And this 3-member ring, which involves the delocalization, so it has 4 pi electron. This negative charge also taking part in the resonance. So it obeys 4n rule, hence it is anti-aromatic. So in the compound, one part is anti-aromatic and another part is aromatic, then the entire system will be non-aromatic. And here, if remove this bond, it is taken by negative charge, it has 6 pi electron. Okay. So this side alkene is attached. So among this, this is the stable one, which has both the parts are aromatic, aromatic, and gives the entire compound will be aromatic, which has maximum charge separation here. So which has maximum stability. So hence this option B is has highest dipole moment. Fifth question. Consider the following statements for 18 aniline. And this is the structure of 18 aniline. They have already given. If you count the pi bond, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So totally 9 pi bonds. So 9 into 2, 18 pi electrons. So it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule if you put n equal to 4. So hence this compound is aromatic. See the options. It is aromatic. So it is correct only. Exactly right, aromatic. The inner protons resonate at 9.28 in its NMR spectrum. There are 6 protons in the shielded zone. If you see inside the ring, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there are 6 inner protons and as 9 outer protons. So there are 6 protons in the shielded zone. Because these protons experiencing highly steric effect, overcrowded, due to this overcrowded, ring current is playing. That is, this proton, 6 protons have, that is, these 6 protons resonate at 9.28 in its NMR spectrum, it's wrong. Because this inner proton, the electron around these protons creates a magnetic field. This induced magnetic field by the electrons opposes the applied magnetic field. So this proton resonate at low delta O value. So low delta O value means shielded zone. So there are 6 protons in the shield zone, is correct. So these protons have low delta O value instead of high delta O value. So the option B is wrong. Because the inner protons resonate at 9.28 chemical shift. They given 9.28 chemical shift in its NMR spectrum. It's wrong. Because these protons are 9.28 means highly deshielded. Highly deshielded. Okay. Again, this question from 18 aniline. The proton NMR spectrum of 18 aniline shows. Now only I said. First option. If you see first option, only one peak at 7.2 for 18 protons. They are totally given for 18 protons. That is, they are giving only one signal. That is around 7.2. And second option, only one peak at 5.0. That is in the shielded zone. 18 protons are in the shielded zone. Then two peaks at 9.0, 12 protons, and one peak at 9.0 and another peak at -3.0. That is 6 protons. And D option, two peaks at 9.0 for 6 protons and -3.0 for 12 protons, which is going to be correct. As I told you already, the 18 aniline has 6 inner protons which are having the overcrowding. So due to this overcrowding, this is a diatropic molecule which experiences ring current. This electron of protons oppose the external magnetic field and resonate these protons at low delta O value, because these protons are highly shielded protons compared to the outer protons. So the inner protons are highly shielded, which has low delta O value. So the low delta O value means among this, the two options. So there are two peaks are available for 18 annealing in the NMR spectrum. So for the one peak, -3.0 for 6 protons. This is the 6 inner protons which having the low delta O value. The outer protons, the 12 outer protons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the 12 outer protons have in the deshielded zone. So it has high delta O value, that is 9.0. So the option C is correct. And seventh question, the correct order of the basicity of the following compounds. Basicity means, let's see, the lone pair of electrons are available for the proton acceptor. Let's see the basicity of the nitrogen containing compounds. Here the first option, it's a pyrrole. But see here, this lone pair electrons are involved in the delocalization and gives 6 pi electrons, hence it is aromatic. And here also the lone pair is taking part in the delocalization and it gives 10 pi electron, hence it is also a aromatic. It's a quinoline. Next one is pyridine. See, if you see pyridine, this nitrogen does not give its lone pair, it's free now. So totally it has 3 pi bond, it has 6 pi electron, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule and again it is aromatic. This is piperidine. The lone pair electron of nitrogen atom does not involve in the resonance. Okay, so it's a free for conjugation. So among this, which is more basic? Because this nitrogen, if you see the piperidine, this nitrogen has lone pair which does not have any conjugation, because there is no alternate double and single bonds, it does not involve in the conjugation. So this lone pair is free for proton acceptor. So it is more basic. Next, this pyridine molecule does not give its lone pair because this nitrogen already having the pi bond, because this is sp2 nitrogen. This is sp2 nitrogen. This lone pair is free now. So hence this compound is free for basicity. So it also basic. So this is first and this is second. And if you compare this and this, which is more basic, you see a quinoline. This lone pair involved in the delocalization. This nitrogen also having involved in the delocalization. But near this, the steric effect, bulky group is present. The bulky ring is present. So, which is not free. This electron is not free for conjugation. So, this is, compared to first and second, this is basic. This is more basic than this quinoline. So, basicity order will be piperidine 4, then third, and compare A and B option. First is the basic, then least basic is quinoline. So among this, piperidine is more basic because the lone pair electron is not involved in the conjugation. It's free, so it readily accepts the proton. So basic means which will accept the proton, is acidic means which release the proton readily. Next question, among the carbocations, the aromatic cation is aromatic cation, which is going to be aromatic. We see this 1, 2, 3, 6 pi electron. But this carbon is sp3 carbon. So homotropylium cation. This homotropylium cation, this sp3 carbon goes out of the plane like this. So if you take this part alone, it has 6 pi electron, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic, not aromatic, simply aromatic, so homo aromatic. So homo aromatic. Next option, cyclopentadienyl cation has 4 pi electron and it obeys 4n rule, hence it is anti aromatic. And cyclopropanol cation, it has 2 pi electron involved in the resonance. So 4n plus 2 rule, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. So among the three options, the aromatic cation is C. Next question, which of the following are converted to an aromatic substance on loss of hydride ion, which is going to be aromatic after losing its hydride ion. Hydride ion means H minus ion. So the compound has to give H minus ion. So if the H minus is given out, then the compound become positive and H minus. So now study the aromaticity of the compound. It has 2 pi electron, so it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence this compound is aromatic. After losing hydride ion, this cyclopentadiene positive charge, if we count the pi electrons, so 1, 2, totally it has 2 pi bonds, so totally 4 pi electrons, it obeys 4n rule, hence it is anti-aromatic, it obeys 4n rule. And C, if it loses hydride, so if you count the pi bonds, 1, 2, 3, 3 pi bonds, so 6 pi electrons involved in the conjugation, because alternate single and double bond, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence this compound is aromatic. Next option, after losing H minus ion, so this negative charge involved in the conjugation, it has 6 pi electron, hence it also aromatic. Sorry, this is not negative charge, is not here. If you see this compound, it has 2 pi electron, but this carbon is sp3 carbon. sp3 carbon means, so hence if this compound is non-aromatic, because no planarity, non-aromatic. So among the 5 options, which are all aromatic, means option A is aromatic, and option C is aromatic, option D is aromatic. Next question, among the following compound, the aromatic compound is the first option. We see there are 3 nitrogen atoms in it, then all are sp2 nitrogen atoms, so it have pi bond near it, so it does not give its lone pair for the delocalization, so it has 3 pi bonds, so 6 pi electrons, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, and it is aromatic. This oxygen has, the second option, this oxygen has lone pair, it gives its electrons for delocalization, so it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, because it has 6 pi electrons, hence it is aromatic. Sorry, it will be like this. Again, there are 2 oxygen atoms. This oxygen gives this lone pair for the delocalization, hence this is 6 pi electron system, hence this is aromatic. And if you see, this is totally in this compound 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, totally 7 pi bonds. So 7 into 2, 14 pi electrons. 14 pi electrons means it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule. That is, if n equal to 3. So hence it is aromatic. So all the 4 options are, given 4 options are aromatic. So if you see the option here, so all of this. And next question, find the most acidic species among the following, which is going to be more acidic. Acidic means it's ready to give its proton. After losing proton, less than negative minus, so it becomes the lone pair of electrons is here. Whenever the acidity type of questions are asked, the questions are mainly based on the aromaticity of the compounds. Let's see the aromaticity of the following product. After losing proton, it becomes like this. The lone pair electron does not involved in anything. So next, if you see here, this proton involved in the delocalization, so it has 6 pi electron. Hence it is obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. And here this nitrogen does not give its lone pair for a delocalization because it is sp2 nitrogen. It obeys 6 pi electron 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it also a aromatic. Here this nitrogen lone pair again does not give its lone pair for the delocalization, hence it is 6, it obeys 6 pi electron because 3 pi bonds and again aromatic. So these are aromatic. But option A, this electrons, the electron in this case does not involved in the conjugation. So all these are aromatic rest of this compound. You see, this carbon is sp3 carbon, hence this is non-aromatic. And if you see this, before losing the proton, it has 4 pi electron, hence it is obeys 4n plus rule, hence it is anti-aromatic. It is 6 pi electron, it obeys 4n plus rule, again so aromatic before losing, so it also a aromatic. So among this is non-aromatic, it's a omitted among the three. So it's aromatic is converted to aromatic, but the option B, the anti-aromatic tends to form aromatic. So anti-aromatic compounds are least stable. If you see the stability order, aromatic is more stable than homoaromatic, then non-aromatic, then anti-aromatic. So this is the stability order of the compounds. So the anti-aromatic compounds are readily tend to form the stable compounds like aromatic. So the option B is right. So if whenever the acidity asked in the questions, so this acidity type of questions are mainly based on the aromaticity. So first predict the aromaticity of the reactant, and then after losing the proton, and again predict the aromaticity of the product, then compare that. So which is going to be more acidic based on the aromaticity. Then finally predict the product. Next question, find the correct order of rate of solvolysis. Solvolysis, that is solvolysis means it may be happening in the SN1, SN2 reaction. Alkyl halides undergo the elimination reaction in the presence of nucleophile. Correct order of rate of solvolysis. First, remove the. This is a aryl halide. When we go undergo the SN1 or SN2 reaction, it loses this halide. It's a positive charge. So before this, it does 4 pi electron. It obeys 4 in rule. It's anti-aromatic. It has again 4 pi electron. Anti-aromatic. Next, after losing bromate ion, before that it has 6 pi electron. It obeys 4 in plus 2 aromatic. Again 6 pi electron, hence it is aromatic. So it has 6 pi electron, again aromatic. After losing bromate ion, so again 6 pi electron, it is aromatic. Listen, it has 6 pi electron, sorry, it is not aromatic, it's a non-aromatic species, non-aromatic as sp3 carbon. So among this, anti-aromatic is converted into anti-aromatic species, and aromatic is converted to aromatic species, and non-aromatic is converted into aromatic species. As I told you already in the previous question, if any compound, any aromatic compounds, that is instability compounds, are tend to form stable compounds, then the order of stability will be very high in that case. So here this non-aromatic compounds are effectively tend to form aromatic compounds. So the order of solvolysis will be, this will go for first, and this will go for second, and this will go for third. Because the non-aromatic compounds tend to form aromatic, because this is sp3 carbon, it has 6 pi electron, it is a non-aromatic one. So the order of solvolysis will be, so option B is undergo higher rate, then C, then A. Okay. Then next question, arrange the following compounds the increasing order of hydrogenation. So increasing order of hydrogenation. What is meant by hydrogenation? Adding of hydrogen. So this hydrogenation is used to study the stability of double bonds, stability of carbon-carbon bonds. So the hydrogenation is inversely proportional to stability. Hydrogenation is inversely proportional to stability. So predict the aromaticity of the following compounds. It has 6 pi electron, but this carbon is sp3 carbon, hence it is a non-aromatic. If you see this compound, it's a cycloheptatrienyl cation. It has 6 pi electron. It obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. And it is cycloheptatrienyl anion. So this negative charge involved in the delocalization. So totally it has 8 pi electron. It obeys 4N rule. And hence it is anti-aromatic. If you write the stability order for these compounds, for the given options, the option B is highly stable because it is aromatic, then non-aromatic A, then anti-aromatic. As I told you already, the stability is inversely proportional to hydrogenation. So here hydrogenation for C is very high, then A, then B. So the hydrogenation reaction of, if you see the hydrogenation reaction of benzene, it has 36 kilocalorie per mole of resonance energy. So it has less value, less heat of hydrogenation compared to other compounds because of the extraordinary aromatic stability of the benzene compound. So benzene has 3 pi bonds in it. Benzene has totally 3 pi bonds. So all the 3 pi bonds are equal length and equal size. So because of this, the pi electrons and above and below are delocalized. So pi electrons are continuously delocalized above and below of the plane. So hence the aromaticity is very high and highly stable. Benzene is highly stable. Hence it has less heat of hydrogenation. So because of its high stability. Next. Arrange the following compounds the increasing order of the pKa values. So for pKa values, they have to release the proton readily to give the proton. So if it removes a proton, we have already one negative charge, so totally it has two negative charge. So before that it has 6 pi electron. It obeys 4m plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. Now it has 2 more electrons is here, so totally 8 pi electron, hence it is anti-aromatic because it obeys 4n rule. Next, after losing proton, before that it has 2 pi electron, hence it is aromatic. Now it has 4 pi electron, hence it is anti-aromatic. Before this, it has 4 pi electron, hence it is anti-aromatic. It has 6 pi electron, hence it is aromatic. Here, if you see, aromatic is converted into anti-aromatic. Here, aromatic is again converted into, it is a non-aromatic one because this carbon is sp3 carbon, so non-aromatic. This compound is non-aromatic. Then option C is anti-aromatic is converted into aromatic. So acidity order will be, because this anti-aromatic is tend to form aromaticity to gain extra stability after losing proton. So this will undergo acidic, acidity will be very high for this option C. Then option B, then option A. So acidity will be in this order. So option C is more acidic because the anti-aromatic compounds are tend to form aromaticity because it get extra stability. So here aromatic become non-aromatic. Aromatic become anti-aromatic. Anti-aromatic compounds are least stable compared to this and this. Anti-aromatic compounds are least stable, so it will have less acidity. So if you see the pKa order, acidity is inversely proportional to pKa. So A as high pKa, then B, then C. Okay. Next question: which of the following compounds will give yellow precipitate on heating with AgNO3? So which of the following compounds will give yellow precipitate on treating with AgNO3? So if we treat aqueous and silver nitrate, so AgBr will just go off. So it then converted into this type. After AgBr loss, it forms . And if you see the aromaticity of this compound, it has 2 pi electron, hence it is aromatic. This carbon, if you see this compound product, it is sp3 carbon, so hence it is non-aromatic. And if you see this carbon also sp3 carbon, again it is a non-aromatic. So option A will undergo, because it forming a stable compound, stable product, aromatic product. So hence the compound A will undergo reaction with silver nitrate readily. Okay. See, whenever the acidity and basicity questions are asked like this, we have to see the first aromaticity. So these questions are based on aromaticity. So we have to keep it in mind. Okay. Next, which of the following compounds undergoes elimination reaction readily? So elimination, what is elimination? Elimination are two types, E1 and E2 reactions. Something is going to eliminate from the reactant. That is, so the beta hydrogen going to eliminate from this reactant. So after losing the beta proton, it forms. So this is beta proton, so it will go, takes HBr and form the alkene. Elimination means forming a double bond in the product. So it will form double bonded compound, that is alkene molecule, which has 2 pi electron and obeys 4n plus 2 pyrrole and it is aromatic. Next, again this bromine losses by taking the beta hydrogen, it forms 2 pi electron. And if you see this carbon is sp3 carbon, so hence it is non-aromatic. Right, this hydrogen is losses. You see now it has 2 pi electron, but this carbon is sp3 carbon. Sp3 carbon. Okay, compound comprises of sp3 carbon. There is no planarity maintained. Hence, disruption of delocalization. Hence, this compound become non-aromatic. Here, both the carbons are sp3 carbon. 2 pi electron. Even though it has 2 pi electron, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, but the carbon is sp3 carbon and becomes non-aromatic. So all are non-aromatic, they are not stable. This option A forming a stable aromatic species, and hence the option A would undergo elimination reaction very fastly. Next question. Which of the following compounds, carbonyl compounds, form aromatic cation on protonation? Protonation means accept of proton, adding the proton into the molecule. So when you add this proton, this becomes, this oxygen will take its pi bond, because oxygen is highly electronegative group, and take this proton, then becomes OH. Okay. So now it has 2 pi electron. Hence it is, it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule, hence it is aromatic. This 5 member ring. So 4 pi electron involved in the conjugation, it obeys 4n rule, hence it is anti-aromatic. Similarly, if you take by this oxygen, so the 3 pi bonds, as 6 pi electrons involved in the resonance, so it obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule. 4n plus 2 pi rule obeys, and it is aromatic. You see, this system has 4 pi electron. It obeys 4n rule, hence it is anti-aromatic. And if you see this carbon, this lone pair electron involved in the delocalization, hence it has 6 pi electron, hence it is aromatic. Okay, now it has 2 pi electron. If you see the aromaticity, this carbon is sp3 carbon, hence it is not aromatic. So among these options, so this is aromatic cation, and this also aromatic cation, and this also a aromatic cation. And if you see, this carbon is sp3 carbon, sorry, it is a non-aromatic. Even though it's obeying 4n rule, it should be anti-aromatic, but the presence of sp3 carbon, it has becomes non-aromatic. So among this A, C and E, these are aromatic in nature. Next question, correct match for the product of reaction in column A with column B. So match that. So when we add the cyclooctatetraene COT, when you add cyclooctatetraene with potassium, it becomes two negative charge. So totally now it has 8, 9, 10, 6, 8, 9, 10, 10 pi electrons. It obeys 4n plus 2 pi rule. Okay, then if you add sulfuric acid with the COT cycle octatetraene, it forms cycloheptatrienyl cation, that is cycloheptatrienyl cation. So this carbon is sp3 carbon. This carbon goes out of the plane . So hence, if you consider this part alone, it has 6 pi electron. It obeys 4N plus 2 pi. It's a homo aromatic, because in the system, one of the carbon goes out of the plane. So consider this part alone, following this, so it becomes homo aromatic. So option B is homo aromatic, and option C. This is a sigmatropic reaction. If it undergoes the sigmatropic reaction, which is a concerted reaction, it will form cyclooctatetraene. It has 8 pi electron. It should be anti-aromatic. But cyclooctatetraene is a non-planar molecule, because it dissolves the structure. It should be converted into, it tend to be like this. Tub shaped structure, hence this compound is non-aromatic. So option C is non-aromatic. Then here the two electrons are added, it becomes, so now it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So totally it has 7 to 14 pi electrons. So after addition of this, it gives 2 more electrons, so totally it has 16 pi electrons. So 16 pi electron means it obeys 4N rule, so hence it is anti-aromatic. This is D, so this is will be A. So cyclooctatetraene, after getting 2 negative charge, so it becomes aromatic. This COT, after taking H plus ion from acid, it becomes homo aromatic. This molecule becomes undergo sigmatropic concerted reaction. It becomes cyclooctatetraene, 8 pi electron. So it prefers the structure, tub shaped structure. So it becomes non-planar and it is non-aromatic. So this compound, aniline, will undergo the taken this negative charge and becomes 16 pi electron system. So 16 pi electron is given by the 4N rule. Hence this is anti-aromatic. Next, write the order of basicity of the following compounds with their pKa values. First, predict the basicity. Basicity means it is ready to accept the protons. If you see, it's a piperidine molecule. Piperidine is a more basic, you know it, because this lone pair of electrons are not involved in the delocalization. So hence it is, so no delocalization. Hence this is more basic. This is more basic. So it should have the, among this 4 options, 11.27, 5.2, 0.4. So which has the highest pKa value means the 11.2 is more value. So it's more basic. And if in second molecule, it's a pyrimidazine like molecule, 2 nitrogens. So in this nitrogens, this nitrogen does not give its lone pair for the delocalization, because it has already, it's a sp2 nitrogen. But this nitrogen gives its lone pair because this gives the electron for the delocalization, so it's not available. Okay, so this will give the delocalization electrons for the conjugation with the proton. So hence it also a basic. So the basicity will be like this, 7. Then pyrimidine. So pyrimidine also does not give its lone pair because it is a sp2 nitrogen. It's having a pi bond in it. So the 6 pi electron, it's aromatic. And if you compare both this, this is pyrrole. This will give the lone pair for conjugation. So this lone pair is not available for the proton acceptance. So it is a less basic. So it has 0.4 of pKb value. So it is, compared to this and this, this having 2 nitrogens. This having 2 nitrogens. So one nitrogen is free for delocalization. One nitrogen is given the electrons for the delocalization. One nitrogen is free for proton acceptor. So hence this is more basic compared to this. So this is 5.2. So first option is 11.2, 7, 5.2, 0.4. So among this option, so A is the right. Okay. And last question. So among the following, the molecule in each pair compounds is the stronger base. Again, which is going to be a stronger base. So which is readily gives the electrons, lone pair of electrons for the proton conjugation. In A, we see that the lone pair of electrons, this is pyrrole molecule. So these lone pair of electrons are involved in the conjugation because it gains the aromaticity, aromatic 6 pi electron system, strobase 4 and plus 2 pyrrole. So these lone pair of electrons are not involved in the, involved in the conjugation. So it is not a stronger base. But here all the nitrogen is carbons are sp3 carbon, there is no pi bond in it, so this nitrogen does not give its lone pair for the conjugation. It is free for the ready to accept the electric proton, so it is highly basic, so it is stronger base. And option B, again pyrrole is not a stronger base because it does not give its lone pair. Here, this also 6 pi electron system, this also 6 pi electron system, this also aromatic and this also aromatic, both are stable. And if you see the pyridine molecule, the lone pair electron on the nitrogen atom does not involve in the delocalization. So hence it's a free for proton accept. So in here, this nitrogen gives its lone pair for the electron conjugation. That is, it undergoes the resonance in the system, entire system. So this nitrogen has free lone pair for conjugation with proton. So it is a stronger base. So compared to pyrrole and pyrimidine, so pyridine is a stronger base. And here it has one negative charge, that is one lone pair, and it has this involved in the delocalization 6 pi electron, so it is not free. Again, it is a stronger base. Among this, which is going to be strong base because it involved in the delocalization, so this is not a stronger base, so this will be the stronger base. Okay, with this all the practice questions regarding aromaticity gets over. And thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, please comment my video and like and subscribe my video for more videos. Thank you.